In this video, we start working on a DIY turbo back full exhaust system. Stick around. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new, I'm Matt. Let's go ahead and start working on a full turbo back exhaust using a fairly inexpensive eBay 3-inch stainless steel kit. I think it looks pretty awesome. Let's take a look at it. One of these days I'll have time to get this place organized. But for now, let's work on the fun stuff.
What we have here is a good old flea bay stainless steel 3-inch DIY exhaust kit. I've only taken a look at a couple pieces of these, but I can tell you the quality of them are pretty nice. I mean, look at that. What do you think, Apollo? I mean, it's almost show car quality. Even though I'm not that big on exhaust being all nice and shiny, it's under the car. This is just gonna be a fun street car, race car, track car. We'll decide as we go along, but let's finish unboxing.
I officially have my first shirt and cap up for pre-sale.
I even designed the graphics myself.
Well, we print t-shirts for a living. The caps we do in-house as well. This will help support the channel and the build and us as a small business. So all of the proceeds go back towards the build. So be sure to pre-order your t-shirt and your cap. Now back to the build. Get out of there.
There we go.
Let's see what's in the box.
What's in the box?
Oh, yeah. I completely forgot about that. I tossed this little stainless flex pipe piece in there. We'll put that in between the downpipe coming off the turbo, just so we get a little bit of a wiggle. I still can't believe this kit was as cheap as it was. All right, we got a couple 45s, a couple 90s, a couple 180s, a couple straight section pipes. I think this will be all we need to get the job done.
One of the other things that I did get, because I wanted to make this easily removable. There we go. And these were pretty affordable. I think they're like 15 bucks, somewhere around there, but these are 3-inch V-band clamps. Man, these clamps are just, they're pretty sturdy. I like these. So this will essentially bolt up at the downpipe, and then I'll have a midsection toward where I can just take the whole exhaust out and we can go race it. So we got a couple of those.
Here's the old exhaust that was in the car. There's still a piece that's sitting in the car because it's a pain in the butt to get under there to take it out. But once we get up to this point, this is just kind of right over the rear axle suspension. So we'll start here. I mean, to be honest, this is gonna be pretty simple, at least this section. And it's a lot easier now that I've already have had this fit in the car, so we can just mock it up off of this and
it should work out great. Fingers crossed, you know how it goes when you're modifying cars. It doesn't just drop right in.
Okay, we got ourselves a 90 here, or excuse me, a 45. Probably need another 45. That's that section. This guy will go somewhere around there. We'll have to extend that a little bit. We'll take one of these nice long straight pieces. We'll match it up there. And that will get us to a point where we got a couple 90s. We can use that long piece there as part of a tie-in here and also up here. We got a couple scrap bits. I don't like to throw stuff away for this exact reason. We'll probably use the nice shiny piece, but this is just kind of helping me figure it out. Not much to it.
Let's start to Lego this thing together on top of the old exhaust. Yeah, looks like we're gonna need extension there. If she fits now. There we go.
Like her glove.
Let's go ahead and pull the car inside. I moved everything up towards front because ultimately I'm going to need to test fit all this under the car. So let's pull it in.
Apollo, which car are we going in? You have no idea, do you? Is it gonna be this one? Or is it gonna be this one?
Oh
You love your rides, don't you? Let's go.
What's she gonna do on a cold start, Apollo? Warmed up, geez.
E85 life, or just a crappy tune so far?
This car, I want it, 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 I want it.
possible future channel turbo build?
If you're excited about it,
I'm excited about it. I love bugs. I
hate my car.
Okay.
This would be wonderful.
We'll do something about it.
She's pulled into the shop. There's the downpipe that I do need to take care of. There's something that's been bugging me that I haven't talked about yet. Check this out. And that thing that's bugging me is Shannon. You know, I really hate getting under cars, but we're just gonna do like we've done, but like we've done before. We're gonna jack this whole side of the car up so I can lay underneath it and get this done.
That's actually quite terrifying.
Oh, I thought you said something else. I thought you said sexually quite terrifying.
Oh God.
I was like, what? All right, so I'm gonna remove this downpipe. Need to make some modifications to it because the white light's over there.
Oh, you mean the bright side.
Yeah, I know you just sat down, but I just laid on the ground.
I'm doing you a favor.
Maybe. Hand me the damn light.
I did.
This is gonna be really tight quarters, but she is basically mounted up. It's hitting, so I need to pull this back a little bit more towards the oil pan. All right, so we got this part of the downpipe that's rubbing just a little bit. Not too big of a deal. Could become a bigger issue in the future, so we need to make sure that we kind of tilt this way just a little bit. Okay, we got our downpipe modified. Let's tack this piece on in. Definitely would be a better fit. Okay, those modifications worked out pretty nicely. Squeezed by everything quite well. Got a nice path to the cutout in the oil pan. And might be hard to see, but we're no longer in risk of hitting over here. At least a lot less. Ow, my hair. Looks like our V-band will fit quite nicely. Plenty of room. So let's tack the V-band on and then and we'll move on to continuing on with the exhaust. We're moving along nicely. Let's work on the midsection, which I'm working on this little bin here. Kind of test fitted it under the car a little bit, and I need the trim right here, so let's trim that. She's looking pretty dang good. Clearing nicely. We've got our little midsection just kind of stuck in there. So now I need to tack weld all this stuff so we can move on to that long straight section, which will just be easy. She's looking pretty good, check this out. So we got it coming from our exhaust support here up to the back. I'm working on these pieces here. I need to get rid of the old exhaust that's just kind of hanging there. This is where I want to put the other V-band. We'll make it a lot easier to remove the entire exhaust for race days. Now I need to lower this whole frame right here. It's just a couple 19 millimeter bolts. The whole thing just kind of drops down so that way I can get this out and then I can copy this piece and get ourselves a proper
Oops. Get ourselves a proper looking exhaust. I'm not sure. I'm thinking I'm wanting it to just come down kind of like a stock exhaust and just like that. But we shall see.
At least I think it's a 19.
Ooh, shit. Oh, jeez. We are starting to get there. Check this out. I got this all marked off. We'll just cut it right here. I'll take my this little piece over here, kind of holding this up. I'm running out of pieces. I'll have to use this to kind of make this bend. So we'll take that. We'll cut it down towards where we get over here. We'll use portions of our last straight piece, and we'll use this in order to kind of make this bend that goes over the suspension. It's not really a rear axle, but we're getting there. I'm gonna cut that down and start working on this piece. We'll get our hangers all set, get the thing just hung up, and once everything's looking, we'll fully weld the thing up. Let's go. We got this piece all nice and marked up. We're just gonna do a cut here and here. That will essentially give us the same thing we've got going on here. We'll connect it and we're almost home free. We'll make those couple of cuts. We might have to make maybe four more cuts. We'll hang her up and get this thing wrapped up. If only you guys realize how long this is actually taking. I think I spent a lot of time just contemplating what my next move is. She's looking pretty dang good, if I do say so myself. Let's crawl under the car and take a look at it. We are almost there. We're on the home stretch. So I got a V-band hooked up here. Comes up and over. I think we need to adjust this bend that goes over this portion of the subframe. I think I just need to shorten this piece back over here about an inch. And then we need to angle this one just a little bit more so it's straighter this way, and then we can have a piece that will just come up and out right here. Still undecided as to how I'm going to finish it off, but not quite there yet. A little more work to do. We've got this piece over here all nice and adjusted. Now, hopefully all this lines up correct. I think I'm just gonna do kind of an angle tip straight out. So we'll cut this at an angle, we'll toss it in, and we'll see. We'll see how this works out. We're almost there. We got everything adjusted. Now we just have to take everything off the car and fully weld it up and do give this a little bit of a finishing touch. Well, after a lot of hard work, finally got the exhaust done. Check this out. So here are the three main pieces to the whole exhaust system. We got the downpipe from the turbo. So this is a turbo back exhaust system. We got the V-band all welded up. And then this is our little flex pipe here. This is probably the longest stretch. Normally the factory does have it cut right about here, so it's not such a long ass piece. But then I got a V-band that disconnects it right back here. And then this is the exit part. It kind of goes over the rear suspension. It's looking pretty dope. The welds are eh. I mean, some of them look pretty damn good, but still learn how to do this stuff. And then there's stuff like this where it's like having to fill in this lap joint. Just it's a little bit of a nightmare. So let's toss this stuff in the car and we'll see how it sounds. She is finally done. It was a lot of work, but let's see how it sounds.
I can finally hear the engine. The engine is sounding nice and healthy. We don't have any exhaust leaks or anything crazy going on. Oh, much more enjoyable inside of the car now that the sound is going out of the back of the car. Well, let's take her for a spin and we'll do some drive-by sounds. Imagine that, I got it all nice and centered. All right, let's take y'all for a little bit of a spin inside of the car so you can kind of hear, the noise level. And if it's something that possibly you would be interested in, and if you're comfortable dealing with it on a daily driver. I, for one, don't think it's too loud. I can still talk and hear myself clearly. And right now we're at about 2,500 RPMs in first, just to kind of get a basis of how loud it is. On the freeway, it's about what I would normally be doing, about a little over 2 grand, 60, 65, 70. But she sounds pretty good. I'm pretty happy with it. It was definitely a lot of work. It took more days than it might seem like on camera. Woo! I'm pretty happy with that. Very happy with the results. Well, she sounds pretty damn good if I do say so myself. What do you guys think? Let me know down in the comments. Thanks for watching. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. There's lots of y'all that are watching that have yet to subscribe, so please do so. And be sure to give this video a thumbs up because it helps the YouTube algorithm to show some more of my videos to a broader audience. Until next time, peace out with your peace out.